Hello and welcome to session 12, Perform Advanced Analytics in Power BI. I'm Andrew Conniff, a Microsoft technical trainer specializing in data and AI. And today we are discussing analytics in Power BI. So let's get right to it. In this session, we will use the Analyze feature to group, bin, and cluster data and identify patterns and trends. The Analyze feature provides analysis that is generated by Power BI for a selected data point. We use this feature to see if Power BI has found something that hasn't been looked at before, or have Power BI to give a different insight to the data. This feature is useful for analyzing why a data distribution looks the way it does. Instead of exploring the data manually, we use the Analyze feature to get a fast, automated, insightful analysis on the data. Grouping is used for categories of data. And binning is like grouping, but it is used for grouping continuous fields such as numbers and dates. Use the grouping and binning feature to ensure the visuals in the reports display exactly what is intended. This allows for better viewing, analyzing, and exploration of the data and the trends in the visuals. Use grouping or binning to identify clusters, patterns of behavior, data averages, and more. The results of this analysis will provide end users with more specific insights on the data. An outlier is an anomaly in the data, something unexpected or surprising based on historical averages or results. We want to identify outliers to find data points that significantly differ from other data points, then take action to investigate the reasons for those differences. The result of this analysis can make a huge impact on business decision making. The process of identifying outliers involves segmenting data into two groups. One group is the outlier data and the other group is not. It is possible to use calculated columns to identify outliers, but the results would be static until refreshing the data. And a better way is to identify outliers and use a visualization or a DAX formula, as these methods will ensure that the data is dynamic. Clustering allows us to identify a segment or cluster of data that is similar to some data, but very dissimilar to the rest of the data. The process of clustering is different from that of grouping, as discussed earlier. The Power BI clustering feature quickly finds groups of similar data points. It analyzes the semantic model to identify similarities and dissimilarities in the attribute values, and then it separates the data and has similarities into a subset of data. These subsets of data are referred to as clusters. When creating clusters, select the number of clusters to create or leave that blank and allow Power BI to return the relevant clusters of the data. Key performance indicators, or KPIs, are excellent in helping track progress towards a specific goal over time. To use a KPI, we need three pieces of information. We need a unit of measurement that we want to track. So for instance, the total sales or number of employee hires or number of loans serviced, number of students enrolled, etc. And then a goal for that measurement to compare against the progress. And then the time series, for instance, daily, monthly, or yearly. KPIs work best in a series, for instance, showing the daily, monthly, and yearly goals in a section of the Power BI report. Use what-if parameters to run scenarios and scenario type analysis on data. What-if parameters are powerful additions to the Power BI data models and reports because they enable looking at historical data to analyze potential outcomes if a different scenario had occurred. Additionally, what-if parameters can help predict or forecast what could happen in the future. Using the what-if parameter after creating it requires creating a new measure whose value adjusts with the slider. Create complex and unique measures that let your report users visualize the variable of your what-if parameter. However, to keep the example simple, the new measure is the total sales amount with the forecast percentage applied as illustrated in the image on the screen. Microsoft AppSource has a vast library of custom visuals to import into Power BI Desktop. These custom visuals give a wider choice of options when it comes to using advanced analytics. Custom visuals that may solve a business problem that the standard visuals cannot solve, or one that presents the data in a way that the standard visuals do not. These custom visuals include box and whisker plots, variance charts, hierarchical trees, Gantt plots, clustering plots, and much more. Using advanced analytics visuals adds a layer of complexity to our reports, allowing further analysis of the data and developing granularity within visuals. The AI Insights feature allows us to connect to a collection of pre-trained machine learning models that we can apply to the data, enhancing our data preparation efforts. Access AI Insights in the Power Query Editor, and the associated feature and functions are access through the Home and Add Column tabs in Power Query Editor. With Text Analytics and Vision in Power BI, we can apply different algorithms from Azure AI services like Azure AI Foundry, enriching data in Power Query. The services that are supported today are the following: sentiment analysis, key phrase extraction, language detection, and image tagging. The Q&A feature in Power BI lets us explore the data in our own words, using natural language processing to understand and provide answers with visuals. This ability to ask questions is valuable to report authors and report users. It suggests ideas for the type of visuals to display in the report and quickly add those visuals. It gives report users an effective tool they can use to get quick answers to questions about the data independently. This self-help aspect to Power BI saves time for everyone involved. Power BI records the questions that are asked, and this information can be used to set up the Q&A feature to be more effective. The key influencers visual understands the factors affecting a specific metric. It analyzes data, ranks the factors that matter, and then displays those factors as key influencers. The visual also helps contrast the relative importance of those factors, so we can build visuals while understanding what factors impact them and why the visuals appear the way they do. In this example, we have several visuals for the customer service team and now want to understand the factors that most influence the metrics, specifically to figure out what factors affect sales. One factor might be the client type, and another might be the location, and the key influencers visual displays that information for consideration. The decomposition tree is an AI visual used for improvised exploration and conducting root cause analysis. In this example, the current visual for the supply chain team do not answer all the team's questions. In particular, the team wants to be able to analyze the percentage of products that the organization has on back order or out of stock. The decomposition tree visual can help accomplish that task. Let's go to Power BI and see this in action.
So here we are back in our report, and we're going to do a scatter chart. It's going to make this large so we can see it. And we're going to put on our x-axis the sales numbers. Put up sales. We're going to drag it over here to x-axis. And then on the y-axis, we're going to put profit margin. And as you can see, nothing has quite happened yet. So we're going to, in the legend, we're going to put reseller business type. And we're starting to get some information in here. And on the size, we're going to use sales quantity. All right, and we have one last thing to put in. We have our play axis. That's going to be our quarter. So the play axis is going to be the time under which we want to observe. Make sure I've got that. Now you see we have a play icon down here, but we're not quite ready to play this yet. We're going to add some filters. We're going to filter. We're going to add the product category. So filters on this page, product category. All right. And we're going to filter on bikes. There's our filter. Now let's observe. It's a good example of data over time or time intelligence. When we select one of the items, we can see it's travel over time through each of the quarters. Now let's see what happens when we select a different. There. Quite a different result for clothing. And of course, we can play this and watch it in real time. Because we have it selected, we can watch the path of the one that's selected. So next we're going to create a forecast. But for that, we're going to create a line chart. And we'll make it the full size so we can see it. And for this one, we're going to add on the Y axis, the date and the, or X axis, the date, and on the Y axis, the sales. So date, we'll make sure we grab those, and sales. All right, and what we want to do now is we want to add a filter on the page, the year from the date table. Grab the year, And we see we have the filters from the page. And we're going to filter by 2 years, 2019 and 2020. Grab those 2 years. And then we're also going to add, to make this more interesting, the product category to filters on this page. And we'll filter on bikes. All right, now, what we want to do here is select our analytics pane. And what we want to do is find the forecast section. So we have this selected. We're going to go into the visualizations, forecast. We want to turn it on and we want to apply the unit in months and our forecast length being 1 month. Okay, so let's start with turning it on. So we'll change our units to months. Our forecast length will be 1 rather than 10 months all at once. We'll ignore the last 0. The sensitivity we're going to set to, or the seasonality is 365. The confidence interval we're going to set to 80. And we will apply this. Okay, so what we're seeing is our forecast length is the 1 month and it is extended beyond our length. So this section here is the part that we're seeing the forecast on. And we can go through and see what the forecast is. And if we change our filters, let's say to clothing, you see our forecast change. You can change the granularity of this if we want to get a better view. But here's our monthly view. As an example of two different types of analytical visuals, time intelligence and forecasting. That brings us to the end of this demonstration.
This concludes our session. There are many ways to continue your learning journey, and we encourage you to watch other videos in this course or search out your next favorite topic on Microsoft Learn at aka.ms/learn.